Florida's Value Added Model, also known as VAM. VAM gives teachers the best information they've ever had about their impact on their students' learning. Before we discuss how VAM is calculated, it's important to know who actually receives a VAM score. For most educators, the student performance part of their overall evaluation is based on the performance of their students on local assessments created or selected by the district, principal, or teacher. While these assessments produce student performance data, they are not used to produce VAM scores by the state. A smaller group of teachers' evaluations are based on their students' performance on a statewide end-of-course assessment. These include third grade English, Language Arts, and Mathematics, FCAT Science, Biology, Geometry, Civics, and U.S. History. In these cases, the state provides raw student growth scores to districts for these courses, but not VAM scores. Right now, about one-third of teachers in Florida actually receive a VAM score from the Florida Department of Education. This includes 4th through 8th grade math, 4th through 10th grade English Language Arts, and 8th and 9th grade Algebra 1 teachers. The Florida Department of Education provides VAM data to districts. How this is included in a teacher's final evaluation is determined at the district level. Meet Mrs. Apple and her 9th grade English 1 class. Like other teachers who receive a VAM score, Mrs. Apple's VAM score is based on the performance of individual students in her class. But what does that mean? Before Mrs. Apple's VAM score can be determined, we first have to estimate a reasonable expected score for each of her students based on available student information, characteristics that are outside Mrs. Apple's control, and how other students similar to Mrs. Apple's students performed in the classrooms of other teachers across the state. This is important because it levels the playing field by setting reasonable expectations for each student's achievement for the year they are in Mrs. Apple's class. This results in a clear identification of the impact teaching, like that of Mrs. Apple's, had on students' learning. Let's look at one of her students to see how this is done. This is Alvin. Florida's model takes 10 specific characteristics into account when determining a student's expected score. The most significant factor in the model is how Alvin scored on other assessments in the years prior to entering Mrs. Apple's class. Other characteristics include attendance, the number of times a student changed schools within the same school year, age relative to peers in the same grade, the number of related courses, class size, the range of students' prior achievement in that class, and having a unique ability, including a documented learning disability or being gifted, or being an English language learner. Alvin's values for the factors are used to determine his expected score. Now that we have Alvin's expected score, we compare it to the score he actually achieved. You can see in the picture that Mrs. Apple's teaching helped Alvin score higher than the expected score. The difference between a student's expected score and his actual score forms the basis of a teacher's value added, his or her VAM score. When a student scores above what is expected of him or her, like Alvin did, his contribution to his teacher's VAM score is positive. When a student scores below what is expected of him or her, the contribution to his or her teacher's VAM score is negative. To determine Mrs. Apple's raw VAM score for her 9th grade English Language Arts classes, the model uses the actual scores and expected scores of all of her 9th grade English Language Arts students to calculate the average value she added to her students' scores. This is represented by the numbers you see in the picture. Going back to the very first question, what Mrs. Apple's VAM score means, It means that once we take all of the important factors into account to determine reasonable expectations for all of her students, on average, Mrs. Apple's students scored higher on their English language arts assessment than they were expected to, meaning Mrs. Apple had a positive impact on her students' learning. Knowing students' expected scores and actual scores allows teachers to make data-driven decisions on their teaching practices in order to advance the learning of all the students they teach. Look for additional videos on other teacher evaluation topics. Florida's value-added model, providing information and feedback to Florida educators so that all students are prepared to meet standards that prepare them for college, career, and life.